Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a PWM generator circuit. This schematic represents a pulse width modulator, or PWM, generator circuit. The circuit is composed of three blocks, an error amplifier, a comparator, and a triangle wave generator. The circuit utilizes the triangle wave generator and comparator block to generate a PWM waveform with a duty cycle that is inversely proportional to the input voltage. An op-amp and comparator are used in the block on the right to generate a triangular waveform, which is then output to the inverting input of the comparator in the comparator block. Passing the input voltage to the non-inverting pin of the comparator produces the PWM waveform. Providing the PWM waveform as negative feedback to the error amplifier block ensures high accuracy. Since many PWM circuits are used in audio applications, the design goal for this circuit is to convert an input voltage of negative 2 volts to 2 volts audio signal to a 50 millivolt to 5 volt 500 kilohertz PWM output. The duty cycle of the output will vary from slightly less than 100% for a negative 2 volt input to slightly more than 0% for a 2 volt input. The circuit is designed to use a single 5 volt supply and a reference voltage of 2.5 volts. The first design step is to set the error amplifier inverting signal gain to minus 1 volt per volt. The gain is equal to negative R4 divided by R3. Therefore, we will set R3 and R4 equal to each other. Next, we will select resistors R1 and R2 to divide down the reference voltage and bias the output voltage to 2.5 volts DC. Using the equation for the DC output voltage, VODC, we see that R1 and R2 need to equal R3 and R4 so that VODC equals the reference voltage, VREF. Therefore, we will use 10 kiloohm resistors for R1, R2, R3, and R4. The next step is to set the gain of the triangle wave generator circuit. The output of the triangle wave generator must be greater than the maximum input voltage, VI, to avoid a 0% or 100% duty cycle in the PWM output. Therefore, we will set the maximum output voltage of the triangle wave generator to be 2.1 volts. The amplitude of the triangle wave generator is equal to R5 divided by R6 times V1, where V1 is the comparator output voltage, which is nominally 2.5 volts. Selecting R6 equal to 10 kiloohms, we are able to calculate R5 as 8.42 kiloohms. We will use the next closest standard resistor value of 8.45 kiloohms for this design. Next, we will set the oscillation frequency to 500 kHz. The oscillation frequency, F sub t, is equal to R6 divided by 4 times R7 times R5 times C3. We will select C3 as 100 picofarads, which allows us to calculate R7 as 5.92 kiloohms. We will use the next closest standard resistor value of 5.9 kiloohms for this design. The next step is to select the value for capacitor C1 in order to limit the amplifier bandwidth below the switching frequency, yet above the range of audio frequencies. The cutoff frequency, F sub p, is calculated as 1 divided by 2 times pi times R4 times C1. Selecting a 100 picofarad capacitor sets the cutoff frequency to 159 kHz, which is well below the switching frequency and will not interfere with the audio band. Lastly, we will select the capacitor value for C2 to filter noise from the reference voltage, VREF. The cutoff frequency due to C2 is equal to 1 divided by 2 times pi times C2 times the equivalent resistance of R1 in parallel with R2. Selecting a capacitor value of 100 nanofarads for C2 sets a cutoff frequency of 320 Hz, which will filter most of the noise in the audio band. Running a transient analysis with a 20 kHz sinusoidal audio input, we see that the desired PWM output is produced. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. When designing a PWM generator circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use a comparator with a push-pull output and minimal propagation delay. Next, select an op amp with sufficient slew rate, bandwidth, and output voltage swing. Finally, place the pole created by C1 below the switching frequency and well above the audio frequency range. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a PWM generator circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.